First of all, thanks for clicking, and I am sure you are having a fantastic day. Well, in this video, I'll show you how to make this parallax animation in Figma. Parallax animations are very trendy nowadays, looks really cool, give you a depth of field in your website. Fantastic. Hi, this is ababir. Welcome to my channel Design Thinking. Let's get into it. There will be 5 pages to make this parallax animation transition. And these are all the assets that I'm going to use to design this fake coffee shop mobile app. I used Photoshop to make this blur and this transparent. I made this using a 3D Figma plugin, and I'll definitely make a video on it. So if you want to see that video, please subscribe. These are some SVGs for decoration, a logo, and an arrow icon. Now let's start building. Let's place this background image first. Make it large and drag it into the frame. As you can see, the image is bigger than the frame, and that is intentional, by the way. Now let's place this transparent image. I will put it down a little. I think that's fine. I'll make this background image a bit warm to match the coffee cup image. Okay, nice. Now I'll place the logo. Here I will add a text, and I'm going to name this Good Morning Coffee Shop. Very quickly, I'll fix the typography. Give it a shadow. I'll reduce the line height too. One item is missing, and that is this arrow. Make it white. Let's give it a shadow too. And our first page is done. Now I'll make a duplicate of it. Just hold Alt, select the frame, and drag. On this page, I will make this font small, reduce the line height. Now I'll pull this layer up, but not too much. Place this arrow here. I am placing a solid rectangle. Give it a dark color, not this one. Yep, this one looks more like coffee. Give it a linear color gradient, reverse it. Let's put a text here. Okay, let me pause it here. Let's understand the concept. I'll use a smart animate feature of Figma. So when I click on this arrow, I want this to go up, and it will also bring the text with it. So to achieve that, I have to put this text and the solid layer in the previous frame too. And now I'll push it down till it's out of the frame's visibility, but in the frame. If it's out of the frame, it will not work. You can do this using the keyboard's down arrow key also. The smart animate feature will analyze the positions of the layer and will figure it out. You want this to come up in the next frame, and it will do it. Not to mention that layer's name should also be the same in both frames. Bit confusing. Don't worry, just keep watching. I also forgot to move this background image. Now I'll make another duplicate of it. Here I'll move the background up. Move this up too. I'll make this text smaller and place it just beside the logo. I'll make this solid layer bigger and cover the background from the linear gradient option from here. Move this text. Place this coffee bag in the middle. Push this up a little too. Again, I want this to come up from down here. So I have to put this coffee bag in this frame and push it down out of the visibility. I'll put some decorative SVGs very randomly, very quickly. Again, I want this to come up too, so I have to put this in the previous frame also and push this down out of the visibility, not the frame, but the frame's visibility. These are still inside the frames. Now the fourth page. Move it down. I want a card here with a simple description. Give it a border radius. A deep thick border. I'll make this transparent and convert it into a frosted glass. So apply background blur. Paste an icon here with some simple text. These are, by the way, some demo text that I used. Done. Now let's group it. Now I'll repeat the same. Paste this in the previous frame and push it down, not out of the frame, but out of the frame's visibility. To paste it in the exact same place, I just select the frame and Ctrl V. I will also push this up and add a new item here. Now, the final page. Let's replace this bag. Push it up. Wait, I need a copy of it. Now push this up. Position this correctly and rename this to dark. As you can see, this is group number 2 and this one is group number 1. Now I have to repeat the same for this group number 2 also. Move these two, add a few more. Do the same for this also. I have to add a back button to go to the previous page, so I'll just use this arrow. Everything looks perfect and I hope it will work. Let's prototype this. It started with this arrow to the second frame, so on click it will navigate to this frame. I'll set it to smart animate with the 1 second duration. Apply the same for the rest of the down arrows. Okay, down arrows are done. Now I'll apply the same for the back arrows too. As you can see, prototyping properties are the same. And that's it, it's done. Now let's see. And it is working perfectly, looked fantastic too, right? Did you like this design and this Figma tutorial? Let me know in the comment section. And in the future video, I'll show you how to make this video game-like page using Figma only. Seriously, and it will be awesome. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want more videos like this, please subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching and I will see you in the next video.